Did you just build an AI agent on JotForm and you want to test out the web call agent? Well, let me show you how it works so you can take full advantage of it. Let's jump over to my desktop right now. Welcome to JotForm. My name is George, and on this video, I'm going to show you how to use the web call agent for your AI agent on JotForm. Now, the beauty about this is that you don't actually need a phone number. This is a totally web agent that we can actually give it a call. And there's several settings that we can tweak. So let me show you how to do this right now. So link provided in the description for the voice agent system so you can check it out for yourself. But let's go ahead and jump into our workspace. So this is my JotForm workspace. And currently I am viewing everything that's going on JotForm, including forms, apps, agents, tables, etc. But if you want to just have a clear view of your agents, go ahead and click on the top menu. Go to my agents, and in this section, we'll be able to find the AI agents. In this case, I want to use Brewster as my test. So I'm going to go into edit agent. And as I mentioned before, there is a web voice agent. That means that we're going to be able to use it right now and right here. So in the build section, this is the build tab. There's a voice option available here. If I click on it, we'll be able to view it right here. Now, first thing I want to do is go ahead and test it so you can see how it actually works right now. And then we'll go into tweaking the settings. So let's jump into preview. You have the option to talk to Brewster in this case, and there's the standalone. Remember, we are located right now in the preview section. This is the main channel. You can see here the standalone, and we have the option for chat and for call. In this case, we want to do the web agent call. So let's go ahead and call it right now. Let's talk to Brewster in this case. And it's now connecting
Welcome
me
back.
To Brewster.
Welcome back. AI. I remember you love the V60 style. What do you enjoy most about it?
I like the flavors that it provides. I'm kind of toasty and it just really pops out. What do you think? Is there a better method for coffee brewing?
The V60 method is fantastic for bringing out those toasty flavors. For a different experience, you might try espresso, which offers a rich and intense flavor profile.
Okay, so you can see that Brewster is now responding to my queries as I ask it, and this is a web agent. So if we embed this on a website, if we share the link, customers, clients, fans, etc., will be able to actually talk to your AI agent via voice. Now I can mute this, I can end the call, and I can view the details over here in case I actually want to jump into chat, keep voice, or connect to forms, chat history, or log out. So in this case, I'm going to end the call with Brewster, okay? I can call it back again and I can go back to chat. In this case, let's head on out of here of the preview. And again, we're gonna go into the voice section. So in the voice section, we are going to have the options over here. We have this gear icon that we are going to click on it. And the option that we have right here is to actually change the voice for the web call agent. So right now, Sarah is selected, and you can see here. If I
JotForm
preview this,
AI agents AI are powerful agents tools, are powerful that, tools handle that handle
tasks. Okay, so maybe I don't want to use Sarah. I run a test, and it's just basically not what I want for this particular AI agent. Well, you have several options. You can go ahead and click on play.
JotForm AI agents are powerful tools that handle tasks.
JotForm AI agents are powerful.
JotForm AI agents are powerful tools that.
So you get to understand how they actually sound, but if you want to tweak and have some filters, you can actually change it here. Maybe you don't want to use English. You can go ahead and select another language here, and then these will change. So for example, if I select Spanish, these will update and I'll have Spanish versions that I can use for the AI agent. And I can preview this if I like.
Los agentes de IA de JotForm aumentan.
Okay, see how easy that was? I'll keep it in English. I have options for accents. For example, if I want to use the American accent, the British or Australian, I'll just go ahead and select it here. Gender, if I want to use male, female, or a mascot, just select these options available here. And for the age, there's young and middle age. That way we can filter from all these voices available to select the one that we are looking for. So those are really great options that you have available for the voices. Now, in terms of testing this and getting responses, and maybe you're not getting the correct response, you'll find those options here in training. And in training, you'll want to feed the knowledge base to get these responses. The AI agent will be super smart. It's going to read all this information and it's going to respond in the web call agent, the details that you need. And if there's questions that it doesn't know, you'll find an option like this that says unanswered questions. You'll want to jump into this every once in a while and respond to the questions that people are asking that in this case, this AI agent has no knowledge about. And if we go to publish, we'll be able to view also the voice agent where we're going to have the options to implement the web call voice agent. So in this case, we can go ahead and share this via link. So I can copy this link, go to incognito mode, and just jump into the agent right here. And people will be able to talk to Brewster right now, right here with this web agent. Again, no phone number required for this. Now you can also change the options here for the agent voice. You have the sharing options, QR code, WhatsApp, Facebook, etc. You can view more, or we can embed this on a website. You got an embed code down here for the type of chat that you want to implement. So in this case, there's a page embed, which will be the whole page. There's a chat bot embed. Then again, these codes changes based on what you select, and you're going to get customization buttons here depending on what you select. For example, this is a customization for the chat bubble that you're going to have on the right or the left. You can select it here and get those settings right here. You have your WordPress embed option, your lightbox, and a pop-up option available right there. So several options to embed your web call agent on your website. So I thank you all for watching. Please let me know here in the comments what you think about the web call agents and what you would like to see in the future. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that little bell notification to get notified when new videos come out. And that is a wrap.